Welcome back to Metal, everybody. Here is another man where a lot of questions lie about his allegiance. Jerry Lynn, at one time a part of ECW.
All because of the schedule for football. Introducing first from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 215 pounds, Jerry Lynn.
Jerry Lynn, former light heavyweight champion here in the World Wrestling Federation.
21 pounds, Jason Sugarman.
Jason Sugarman will be the opponent of Jerry Lynn, who at one time held the ECW title and was one of their top stars. Coming over to the World Wrestling Federation, Jerry Lynn said was his dream that he's held his entire life. In his first match in the WWF, Jerry Lynn became the light heavyweight champion. But subsequently, Jerry Lynn, I think, has been frustrated, Michael, and not being able to regain that light heavyweight title. Could Jerry Lynn be the next one to defect going back to his ECW roots?
I don't know. It wouldn't surprise me, but I'd be frustrated if I looked like that, too.
Well, as you know, you as now Mr. Blackwell, I guess, for the World Wrestling Federation, Jason Sugarman trying his best to take down and keep down the former light heavyweight champion.
I'll tell you what, Jerry Lynn is very qualified in that squared circle.
He certainly is. And, you know, what a roster of talent. Oh, wait a minute now. Sugarman surprises Lynn, and all of us here gets a two count. What a roster of talent that Paul Heyman was able to procure from his former ranks and basically hand deliver to Stephanie McMahon Helmsley. You got the Dudley Boys, you got Raven, you got Taz, you got Tommy Dreamer, you got Rob Van Dam. You got a lot of stars in there. You got Lance Storm, Mike Awesome. That's a list.
Palumbo O'Hare.
Yeah, all the WCW guys as well.
Yep. But now let me ask you something. What is the big damn deal about RVD?
I don't know. Rob Van Dam is a top-notch competitor. I'll be very interested to see what he can do in the squared circle here in this environment.
Well, you know what they say sometimes. Nice move. Competition is healthy for business. And maybe that's true. And maybe when they're right now, we're going to get a gut check with the WWF superstars. Maybe we'll see if we're still hungry. Maybe we'll see if we're not tired of being on top of that mountain that will kick anybody down that attempts to take us off our perch.
Well, we will see what happens because, as we know, Mr. McMahon has stood up to the likes of Ted Turner and Time Warner. He's defeated billion-dollar empires before when everyone said he could not. So what will happen now that his own flesh and blood, his son and daughter,
have... Shut your mouth.
Wow, Jerry Lynn getting right into the face of a fan talking about Rob Van Dam, as we mentioned earlier on.
You know what? Rob Van Dam's supposed to be so good. Why did it take 10 other guys to make his move spectacular?
I'm not sure what exactly Rob Van Dam will mean. What will Tommy Dreamer mean to this team, WCW, ECW? Will they be part of the match in Invasion? We're not sure.
Tommy Dreamer is butt ugly.
Okay. Tommy Dreamer is a double tough guy.
He needs to wear a mask. That's how ugly he is.
Let me tell you, Tommy Dreamer could absorb unearthly amounts of punishment.
He should absorb earthly amounts of punishment the way he looks. My gosh.
Well, I think the worst looking one of the bunch has to be Paul Heyman, and I dare you to just speak your mind about Paul E. Come on.
You know what I would like to do with Paul Heyman? I'd like to take him to the top of the Empire State Building, dangle him upside down for about a year and a half till every ounce of fat blood draws out of his nose, and let him go.
Two count only. Jerry Lynn carrying the fight here to Jason Sugarman, a very impressive-looking young man making his Metal debut. We've got tag team action a little bit later on. S.A. Rios and Kay Quick will be teaming up for the first time.
Other than that, Paul Heyman's a great guy.
Well, we'll find out what happens at Invasion 1 week away.
How'd you like to be his girlfriend?
He has a girlfriend?
Just hypothetical situation. Can you imagine waking up next to Paul Heyman?
I'll tell you what, it is going to be very interesting to see what happens on Raw this Monday. We're going to be in Providence, Rhode Island. Does Paul Heyman even think about assuming the color commentary position at ringside? Will Paul Heyman have something more to say about Jim Ross? What about Stone Cold Steve Austin? Will the WWF champion be there? And in what mental state will the Texas Rattlesnake be? Mr. McMahon's begging for the double tough SOB to come back and really start kicking some butt. And I think Mr. McMahon's worried it's not going to happen.
Share that sentiment. Look at Sugarman. He has really took it to Lynn all through this match. We've got to have Stone Cold Steve Austin back. And at this point, I'm so desperate in any form or fashion.
Oh, man. Gorilla press into a power slam. Jack Dunn gets to two. Jerry Lynn kicks out. Maybe Jerry Lynn has a lot of questions on his mind. Has he been offered a spot in ECW? What about the presence?
presence of Rob Van Dam, who was Jerry Lynn's greatest nemesis in ECW. That was the man that Jerry Lynn could never beat.
There it is.
Tornado DDT out of nowhere. If Jerry Lynn hits that, he could beat anybody.
Here is your winner, Jerry Lynn.
I'll tell you what, that was a fantastic move. Sugarman going for a press slam, and Lynn at his best when he counters moves, and he countered that into the Tornado DDT.
We're a week away from Invasion and a week away from the inaugural brawl. We will talk more about that a little